subscribe my channel. P. Sarala. Hit the bell icon so that you are notified every time I post a new lesson.
So today we are going to learn about the midbrain and the hindbrain. So midbrain and hindbrain together known as a brainstem. So this is the brainstem region. So this is the midbrain region and this is the hindbrain. So this is the midbrain and this is the hindbrain region. So midbrain, on the ventral side, it consists of two peduncles which are known as cerebral peduncles or crura cerebri. So this is yellow color ones. So this is the midbrain. So it connects the cerebral hemispheres to the pons of the hindbrain. So it is a connection between the forebrain and the hindbrain. On the dorsal side of the midbrain, four colliculi are present, round bodied structures are present. So the larger upper ones are known as superior colliculi and the smaller lower ones are known as inferior colliculi. So the presence of four optic lobes or colliculi is such condition is known as corpora quadrigemina. So this is also one of the special characteristics of the mammal brain. So these superior colliculi are concerned with the vision and the inferior colliculi are concerned with the auditory function, that is hearing. So the hind brain consists of three structures: pons, cerebellum and medulla oblongata. So this is pons veroli, medulla oblongata and cerebellum constitute the hind brain. So pons is present below the midbrain. So it is where it acts as a relay station between the two lobes of the cerebellum and spinal cord and the rest of the brain, that is the forebrain. So it acts as a relay station, act as a bridge between all these organs. So in the Latin, pons means bridge. Okay, so next, cerebellum. So cerebellum is also second largest part of the brain. So it is also known as a little brain. So it is divided into two equal halves. Those are known as cerebellar hemispheres. So this is right cerebellar hemisphere and this is the left cerebellar hemispheres. So in the middle of these two, a depression is present which is known as vernix. Okay, so each cerebellar hemisphere consists of three lobes: anterior lobe, posterior lobe. The green one is the posterior lobe and the orange one is the flocular lobe. So this is the primitive lobe, archi cerebellum. So the inner side of the cerebellum consists of the white matter. It appears like a tree. That's why it is known as arbor vitae, the tree of life. Surface of the cerebellar hemisphere. So this is the surface of the cerebellar hemispheres is also convoluted. That means it consists of folds like the cerebrum of the forebrain. So this is mainly concerned, cerebellum is mainly concerned with the three important functions: tone of the muscles, coordination of the locomotor movements, and the third one is the posture and the balance of the body. So you have to correlate cerebellum with the balance. Okay, you imagine a drunken person. So he loses his balance. So the coordination is absent in his locomotor organs, that is the legs, all those things. So and it is also very crucial for the motor memory. So what is meant by motor memory? If you learn a typewriter or if you learn any musical instrument, so automatically after practicing for some months, your fingers will move easily. So even if you are close your eyes, you can type the letters on a typewriter or a keypad. So that is known as motor memory. So motor memory is also related to writing. Our writing skills, artistic skills are all under the control of the cerebellum. If a person consumes alcohol, the balance will be, he loses his balance because the alcohol intoxicates the cerebellum. That's why he loses his balance. If any damage occurs to the cerebellum, So the most affected function is the coordination of the body parts. So here you have to remember one thing, that is cerebellar hemispheres. The damage occurs in the right cerebellar hemisphere, so the right side of the body is affected. The left cerebellar hemisphere, the left part of the body is affected, not like the cerebrum. In the cerebrum, so the right cerebral hemisphere controls the left side of the body, but here the cerebellar hemisphere controls the same side of the body. Okay, that is the main difference between cerebrum and cerebellar hemispheres. So next part of medulla oblongata. So medulla oblongata is a conical in shape, a broad side connects with the pons and the narrower end merges with the spinal cord. So medulla oblongata is very crucial because it contains all the centers of the vital functions like respiration, heartbeat, swallowing, vomiting, sneezing, coughing. All the centers are present in this medulla oblongata. So it is very important. So the you can remember the all involuntary functions like digestion, all these are under the control of medulla oblongata. Okay, voluntary functions, voluntary and motor functions are related to the cerebellum. So midbrain and hindbrain together known as a brain stem. So these two together form 20% of the brain. 80% of the brain is formed by the forebrain. Midbrain and hindbrain constitute only the 20% of the brain. So here cerebellum. So the outer region of the cerebellum is also gray in color due to the presence of neural bodies of the neurons, and the inner region is white in color, white matter, due to the presence of all the myelinated axons in the inner part of the cerebellum. Okay, this is about the brain stem.